Good morning, guys. I hope all of you are doing well. So I am CA Kriti Goyal, and I'm going to make a very, very important announcement today because a lot of students have been personally texting me with respect to the various products which are available as far as your paper 3 in CA Intermediate is concerned, which is cost and management accounting. Okay, so let's quickly run through what are the products available and of them what will suit you the most. Okay, so see here. So guys, the first product is regular. Okay, the regular product is of 220 plus hours. So this product is exhaustive in nature. It consists of all the concepts which we thoroughly drill down. We solve a lot of questions in class. More than 300 plus questions are solved in class. And along with that, it also covers the entire ICAI module. 100% coverage, guys. 100% coverage. So if you have never studied cost accounting before, and if you've heard from your friends that, you know, cost accounting is a tough subject, I am not comfortable with cost accounting, then guys, go for this product, because with this, all your concepts will be clear. You can aim at an exemption. Okay, so if you see the books that will be provided with the regular lectures, they include first the Costopedia. Guys, the Costopedia theory book consists of all the theory that we require to know for the examination. Okay, so this book will be given to you. Along with that, it will also have the question bank. So this question bank will consist of all those questions which we have solved in class. Okay, each and every question would have been solved in class. And apart from that, there is also a summary chart book, guys. A summary chart book. So what is the summary chart book? So let me show you. So the summary chart book looks something like this. So this is from our materials chapter. You can see there, material control. So the summary chart book is an incomplete version of my chart book. Now, why is it incomplete? Guys, it is incomplete because you will be completing it in class when you are using my regular lectures, as and when we are doing the concepts. You will be filling up these incomplete parts in your own handwriting so that you are able to retain all the concepts and you feel that you have prepared this book. Okay, so some parts of the book are already provided. There will be a lot of blanks like you see here. So this you will be filling in class as and when we are studying various concepts. So this is the summary chart book. The summary chart book is the completed version of all the chapters that you have in costing, and that is the methodology that we will be using even in class to understand all our concepts. And once the concept is complete, we will be solving questions based on that. So coming back to our first product, which is the regular product, which is 220 plus hours. Remember, if you have not studied costing before, or if you are not comfortable with the subject for whatever reason, then this is the product that you must choose. Okay, coming to the next product, guys. So this product is newly launched. So this is called as Costing Jetpack, and this is that of 120 plus hours. So now, what does this product contain and why would you need to buy this product? So guys, some of you may not have the time to give to the extent of 220 plus hours, right? We have so many other subjects in CA Inter, right? So you may not have that much time, but still you want to, you know, understand the concepts more in depth and get a fair idea of what kind of questions could be asked in the examination. Then in that situation, you can go with the Costing Jetpack. So the Costing Jetpack is 120 plus hours. There is sufficient coverage of questions. All categories, different kinds of questions have been added. So overall, we may have solved around, probably 200 questions in class, putting all the chapters together. Okay. Now, this Costing Jetpack, the books that this particular jetpack will contain includes Costopedia Question Bank, So we will be giving the question bank in this, which consists of all the questions that you will be solving in the class, right? So that is the question bank. And you have the last minute revision chart book, guys, my LMRC. So my LMRC will be given with this Jetpack. So the LMRC, guys, is nothing but the completed version of the summary chart book. Okay, so obviously because it's 120 hours, we do not have that many hours to spare writing stuff in class. So I have written everything and given to you. You can make additional notes in the book. There is a lot of space given in the book. So LMRC will be provided along with the lectures under costing Jetpack. So you can see here the same part which we saw in the summary chart book EOQ. See, this features the completed version of EOQ, right? So we will understand all our concepts from the LMRC, and then based on those concepts we will solve all the questions. So basically the costing Jetpack covers questions from RTP, MTP, previous year's examination papers, from the ICAI module, some additional questions that you know you should be aware of, nicer questions. So all of this is part of your costing Jetpack. Regular, of course, covers 100% of your ICAI module, covers RTPs, MTPs. It also has questions from, you know, other examinations like CMA and CS, correct? And previous year's questions from question papers of CA Inter costing. Okay, so that is the regular product. So if you do not have the time to do the regular lectures, you can go with costing Jetpack. It should serve your purpose. So this is the second product. So guys, I'm doing this because a lot of you have doubts. So I hope this helps you in clarifying your doubts with respect to the various products which are available. Then the next product. Guys, the next product is the Fast Track product. The Fast Track product is 40 plus hours. So let's say you have studied costing, but you had studied costing long back. You have worked out problems also. You know the concepts, but still now because the exams are nearing, you need that last minute push. You know, you need that last minute revision, because when you sit to do the concepts, you tend to feel that, you know, I may not remember the concepts, or it would be great to have help around when it comes to this particular subject. Then guys, go with this product. Okay, go with this product. This is 40 plus hours. You can easily complete it in less than a week's time. Okay, all the concepts are quickly brushed through in this particular Fast Track product. Okay, and we have also solved a lot of questions or sub questions, you know, certain adjustments which are part of bigger questions which tend to confuse us. So all those things have been taken care of in this particular product. And if you see, this is extremely pocket friendly as well. So it is just about 2500 and 3500 if you are going ahead with Google Drive and Pen Drive respectively. Now coming to the books, what books will you be provided? For this particular product, you will have a separate Costopedia Fast Track Theory and Question Bank. So this particular book is only available for this product. And also along with that, you will have the LMRC for your last minute revision. Okay, but I would suggest you go for this product only if you have some basic understanding of the subject. If you are studying the subject for the first time, guys, then this is not the product for you. This is not the product for you. Okay, so this is product number 3. Now coming to guys, product number 4. Product number 4. So this is called as ICAI Questions Booster Pack. So recently there were a lot of amendments as far as the costing syllabus was concerned. So the amendments were more like, you know, they have added new questions to the institute material. There have been some questions in the past which were not solved correctly, which have been rectified, and new questions also have been added. So a lot of students had been texting me, you know, their doubts in relation to, you know, certain questions which they were unable to solve. So what I have done is I have solved all the questions from the ICAI module, guys. All the questions of the ICAI module, and that is what is part of this booster pack. So if you see the ICAI module, we'll take an example. Okay, this is material cost. So if you open the ICAI module, you have questions in between concepts, right? So let's say we are at purchase acquisition, we move forward, then there is valuation of material receipts, we move forward, and then finally you have the first illustration, right? So the questions which are part of the module, okay, in between the chapter, as and when the concepts are flowing, they are called as illustrations, right? And there are some questions which are available also at the back of the chapter. So once the chapter gets over, so if you take material chapter, for example, we have illustration 1, 2, let's see, illustration 7, then let's go to, this is illustration 14. So guys, illustration 14 is the last illustration of the material chapter. So there are totally 14 questions which are part of the entire chapter as a whole, right? So those are in between the chapter. And if you look at the last part of this chapter, which is test your knowledge, here when you look at the practical problems, guys, practical problems in this chapter, how many practical problems do you see? Question number 1 to question number 9. So guys, why am I showing this to you? I'm showing this to you to make you understand how the ICAI module shows the problems. So the first set of problems is the illustrations, which are part of the body of the chapter, right? And the second type of questions are those questions which are available at the end of the chapter, which go by the name practice questions. So this is the flow as far as all chapters are concerned in the ICAI module. So guys, the ICAI booster pack, which is about 100 plus hours, consists of illustrations, practice problems, okay, from all the chapters of the module. 100% coverage, guys, from chapter 1 to chapter 15. Everything is covered. So those students who have never studied from me, okay, but are very, very confused about the ICAI module, can separately purchase this particular pack. Okay, can separately purchase this particular pack. So again, it is extremely wallet friendly. It is just 3999 if you're going with Google Drive and Android, and if you're going with the pen drive mode, then it is 4999. So guys, if you see 200 plus questions from ICAI module, 100% coverage. No books will be given because all of you have the ICAI module. The flow will exactly be like the way it is in the ICAI module, because you should not be confused with respect to any question. So everything has been covered and taken care of. Now you may have a question. Let's say you say, ma'am, I have already purchased your regular lectures, which is that of 220 plus hours. Should I be buying the ICAI booster pack? Guys, no, do not buy this, because this already consists of the ICAI booster pack. This includes additional questions which we have solved in class. Apart from that, it also includes the entire ICAI module. So do not buy this booster pack if you have purchased my regular classes. Coming to Costing Jetpack. If you have purchased Costing Jetpack, should you be purchasing the ICAI booster pack? Guys, from the ICAI module, around 70% of the questions, 70% of the questions are covered in the Costing Jetpack. What did I tell you? Costing Jetpack consists of questions from ICAI module, from RTPs, MTPs, previous year's question papers, right? So 70% of your ICAI questions are covered in the Costing Jetpack already. So if you are confident, then do not purchase the booster pack separately. But however you feel that, no, the questions which are not covered, I'm not very comfortable with them, then you can go ahead and purchase the booster pack. But in my opinion, most of you wouldn't need to do that if you have already purchased the costing jetpack. If you have purchased the fast track, then do you need to purchase the ICI booster pack? Then yes, because fast track is to quickly, you know, sharpen your concepts, the concepts that you already know, right? Because you've already studied them before. But for your last minute push, this is important, right? So obviously, the fast track batch will not include a lot of questions. There are a few questions which are covered from previous year's question papers, few questions from RTPs, some questions maybe, you know, taken from the ICAI booster pack as well. But of course, the coverage as far as ICAI booster pack is concerned, you will not find in the fast track module. Okay, so if you have purchased the fast track module and you are confused about the ICAI booster pack, then you can go ahead and purchase this to ensure that you're not confused about the questions in the ICAI module. Guys, so I hope this helps as far as the products are concerned, their features, their hours, the books that will be provided with each of these products. Okay, if you all have any doubts, you can contact the office at any of these numbers, right? Some of you may have my number. You can personally text me as well. I will be there to help you all. And just to help you all better, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to attach a couple of questions which I have solved from the ICAI module as part of this video, so you can take an informed decision. Okay, so guys, take care, have a great day, and all the very best for your examination. Keep in touch. Bye bye. Guys, question number one in the question bank. Question number one. So I'm going to start reading now. MNP Limited sold 275,000 units of its product at rupees 37.5 per unit. So guys, this is the sales quantity, correct? And this is the selling price per unit. Very clearly given in the problem. Variable costs are 17.5 per unit. So variable cost per unit has been given. They have shown the breakup of this variable cost. Manufacturing costs are 14 rupees and selling costs are 3.5 rupees per unit. So total variable costs come up to 17.5 rupees. Fixed costs are incurred uniformly throughout the year and amounting to 35 lakhs, including depreciation of 15 lakhs. There are no beginning or ending inventory. So they've given us the selling price per unit, they've given us the variable cost per unit, they've given us the fixed cost. I wonder what is left. Required, compute break-even sales level quantity and cash break-even sales level quantity. This you leave now. Okay, we've not even seen it. We will see it in this problem. What are we supposed to do first? Calculate BEP. Then what have they asked? BEP quantity. They have asked us BEP quantity. Guys, how do we calculate BEP quantity? How do we calculate BEP quantity directly in the problem? What was the formula? BEP quantity. So we will take fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. That was the formula for BEP quantity directly without routing it through BEP value. Correct? So let's go to our problem number one. Problem number one. So, selling price per unit, what have they given, guys? They have said 37.5. Variable cost per unit is how much? 17.5. Guys, correct? 17.5. So, I will get my contribution per unit. So, how much do we get contribution? 20 rupees. We get our contribution per unit as 20 rupees, which is selling price minus variable cost. Fixed cost, they have given how much? 35 lakhs. Correct? I need to calculate my BEP quantity. So, how do I calculate BEP quantity, guys? What was the formula for BEP quantity? See here, formula for BEP quantity, fixed cost by contribution per unit. So, fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. So, fixed cost is 35 lakhs. Contribution per unit I've already found out at 20 rupees. So, how much do I get? One lakh seventy-five thousand units, guys. So I need to sell 1,75,000 units in order to recover 35 lakhs of my fixed cost. So at BEP, my profit or loss will be zero. So they have asked for BEP quantity. Very, very simple problem. So if I ask you, this is my from my side, if I ask you to calculate BEP value, how will you calculate, guys? Just to understand, how will we calculate? Now don't sit and calculate PV ratio here and waste time. We have BEP quantity, no? We know that BEP value is nothing but BEP quantity into selling price per unit. Correct? I've already found out my BEP quantity, which is 1,75,000 units. So, 1,75,000 units into what is the selling price, guys? Selling price was 37.5. So, we will get our BEP value. So, basically, this BEP quantity that we got, 1,75,000, this is like our 5 ice creams, right? BEP value is like that 100 rupees, that's all. So, 5 ice creams into 100 you did, right? Here also, we are doing the same thing. Instead of 5, we have 1,75,000 units. 37.5 is nothing but the cost, I mean the selling price, which was 20 in our ice cream example. So, how much do we get? 65,62,500. So, this is the value of sales. Value of sales. This they have not asked. No need to do it in the exam, but now you do it. Because I have asked you to calculate the BEP value. They have very clearly told they only want the BEP quantity. Guys, is it okay? So, this is the first part of the problem where they have asked us to calculate the BEP quantity. Now, they are asking us to calculate cash break-even sales quantity. Guys, cash BEP is nothing but, if you come back here, I have given one formula here. Guys, cash BEP means you only consider cash fixed cost. Only consider cash fixed cost. Depreciation is non-cash. Correct? Depreciation is non-cash. So, anything which is non-cash will not be considered. The rest of the formula remains the same. So, now they have asked us cash BEP. So, how will we calculate cash BEP, guys? So, cash BEP quantity will be fixed cost. Sorry, first you write the formula, cash fixed costs divided by contribution per unit. So, cash fixed cost will be 35 lakhs minus, see they have told no, including depreciation of 15 lakhs, which means we will remove this, correct? So, minus 15 lakhs, so this is my cash BEP. Divided by contribution per unit is the same, which is 20 rupees. So, how much do we get, guys? We will get 1 lakh units. 1 lakh units. Very, very simple. You are given the following particulars. From the following particulars, calculate what? A. Break-even point. We're supposed to calculate break-even point. B. Sales to earn a profit of 20,000 rupees. Okay, so the profit that we are earning is 20,000. But they want the sales figure. How much should we sell so that we earn a profit of 20,000? These are the two things that we need to calculate. What have they given? One, fixed cost is 1,50,000. Two, variable cost is 15 rupees per unit. And three, selling price is 30 rupees per unit. Guys, first, let's calculate on BEP. So, how we'll focus more on BEP first because that is part 1. How do we calculate BEP? Guys, very simple. We know the formula for BEP. They have given us selling price per unit. They have given us variable cost per unit. We can easily calculate break-even point. Now, in this particular problem, they have not told break-even point has to be calculated in quantity or value. What do? Let's do both. Okay, when they have not mentioned whether we need to calculate BEP in quantity or BEP in value, what do? We will calculate both and give it to them. Okay, so let's calculate BEP first. So guys, BEP quantity is fixed cost by contribution per unit. Guys, correct? That is my BEP quantity. What is my contribution per unit? Selling price per unit is how much? They have said it is 30 rupees. So rupees 30 minus variable cost per unit, what have they said? Is 15 rupees. So let's take 15 rupees. So contribution per unit is 15 rupees. Guys, correct? So I can easily calculate my BEP quantity. So BEP quantity is equal to what? Fixed cost. How much is the fixed cost? They said 1,50,000. So 1,50,000 divided by 15 rupees. So how much do I get, guys? 10,000 units. 10,000 units. So my BEP quantity is 10,000 units. I will calculate BEP value also. So BEP value is nothing but BEP quantity into selling price per unit. Guys, can we calculate BEP value instead of BEP quantity and then from BEP value calculate BEP quantity? Sure, please go ahead. If we are calculating BEP value first and not BEP quantity, then what do we need? We need PV ratio. So we will have to calculate the PV ratio in that case. How will we calculate PV ratio? Contribution per unit by selling price, right? So 15 by 30 into 100 will give you PV ratio, which will come up to 50%. Then you calculate your BEP value directly using the formula fixed cost by PV ratio. And then from that you get your BEP quantity. It's absolutely same. You can follow whatever you like. Any formula in any way can be followed. This is what I am following. You want to follow this, you follow this. You want to follow your own method, please go ahead and follow it. There is no hard and fast rule that it has to be done like this only. Okay. So I'm making it very clear. So BEP quantity, I got 10,000 units. How much is selling price per unit, guys? 30. So what do I get? 3 lakhs. So from my side, BEP is done. So this is part A. Part B is also there, no? They've asked us to find out sales to earn a profit of 20,000. So guys, remember we did one formula where, you know, that additional formula we did. Where are those additional formulae? See here. Sales quantity is fixed cost plus profit by contribution per unit. Because I have contribution per unit, I will want to use this particular formula. So, I know that sales quantity is fixed cost plus profit by contribution per unit. Correct? They've asked me to find the sales only. I don't know. So, Fixed cost is how much, guys? Fixed cost is 1,50,000, right? They have directly given me the profit in the problem. They want a profit of 20,000. So 20,000. Contribution per unit I already have calculated. That's why I chose to use this formula, because everything is already there. I don't need to calculate anything extra. So 15 rupees. Correct? Contribution per unit. What do I get, guys? 1,70,000 divided by 15. So I get 11,333.33 units. Correct? So these are the number of units which I will sell, so that my profit will be 20,000. They have asked sales to earn a profit of 20,000, which means they're talking about sales value. So how do we calculate sales value, guys? Sales value for these many units will be 11,333.33 into selling price per unit. How much is the selling price per unit? 30 rupees. 30 rupees. So how much do we get? 3,40,000. 3,40,000. Guys, correct? They've asked for the sales value, not for the number of units. And even if it is confusing, you do both. No? You're not going to lose out on anything because it is not clear. So please calculate both. So in order to make a profit of 20,000, I need to sell 3,40,000 worth of goods. This is what it means. Yes, so problem number 3, PQR Limited has furnished the following data for the 2 years, okay? For 2 years, data has been given. What? Sales, 2019 and 2020. For 2019 is given, for 2020, it's a question mark. Profit volume ratio, PV ratio, 50%, 37.5% in each of the 2 years. Margin of safety, sales as a percentage of total sales, 40%. And in 2020, it is 21.875%. What do you mean by this, guys? What do you mean by this margin of safety sales as a percentage of total sales? I told you, right? Total sales can be divided into BEP sales and MOS sales. So for 2019, they are saying MOS sales are 40%. So can I conveniently say it out of the total sales, 60% will represent BEP sales? And similarly for 2020, they are saying that margin of safety sales represents 21.875% of total sales, which means 100%, which means 100% minus 21.875, which is 78.125% will represent the BEP sales, correct? So that is the meaning of this particular statement. Now let's see what else they have given. There has been substantial savings in the fixed cost in the year 2020. Due to the restructuring process, the company could maintain its sales quantity level of 2019 in 2020 by reducing the selling price. So guys, what they're indirectly trying to tell is, as far as fixed cost is concerned, there have been savings. Okay, there have been savings in 2020, and between 2019 and 2020, guys, the sales quantity, okay, the sales quantity has remained the same. That has not changed. That they were very clearly given that the company could maintain the sales quantity level in 2020, which was there in 2019 and 2020 also. So whatever sales quantity level was there in 2019, same sales quantity level was there in 2020. However, the selling price, guys, the selling price was less in 2020. we don't know anything about selling prices, we don't know anything about sales quantity, nothing else is given. They've only given the total sales in 2019, correct? But what has changed? Only selling price per unit has changed between 2019 and 20, and sales quantity has managed to remain the same. That's it. What now? You are required to calculate the following. What? First, sales for 2020 in value. We have to calculate this question mark. Let's not read 2 and 3. First, let's focus on calculating sales for 2020 in value. Guys, how will we do this? We don't know anything. We don't know the selling price. If we knew the selling price, at least we could have, you know, reduced and known by how much the selling price is reduced, we could have calculated something. But we don't know anything. We only know that the total sales value in 2019 is 8 lakhs. They have given us PV ratio of 2019. Can we use that somehow? Guys, see. In 2019, my sales value was 8 lakhs. Correct? They have said PV ratio is 50%. Guys, can I say my variable cost ratio is 50%? Because variable cost ratio is 100% minus PV ratio. We saw that. So variable cost ratio is 50%. So can I say my variable costs will be 8 lakh into 50%, which is 4 lakh. When variable cost ratio is 50%, what is variable cost ratio? Variable cost by sales into 100. Guys, correct? Just like PV ratio. What was PV ratio? PV ratio was your contribution by sales into 100. Correct? So variable cost ratio we found out was 50%. So can I say that my variable costs, that is this figure, is variable cost ratio into sales? So sales is 8 lakhs, variable cost ratio is 50%, so I've got 4 lakhs. So variable costs are 4 lakhs. Guys, now they have said that the sales quantity in 2019 and 2020 is the same. So can I say my variable cost total in 2020 is 4 lakhs? Because sales quantity has not changed. Variable cost per unit will remain the same. So if sales quantity has not changed, variable cost per unit also is not changing. Variable cost per unit anyway remains the same. So in 2019, it was 4 lakhs. That is quantity into variable cost per unit, both are not changing. In 2020 also it will remain 4 lakhs. Can I say that? So in 2020 my variable cost is 4 lakh. Now I have arrived at this. So from this, can I work backwards and arrive at my sales, guys? Can I do that? So let's go to our classwork. Let's start writing. So first of all, problem number 3. Let's write what they have given to us. Sales value in 2019 is 8 lakhs. PV ratio is 50%. Correct? So can I say variable cost ratio is 100% minus PV ratio, which is 100% minus 50%. So it is 50%. So can I say variable costs in 2019 will be sales into variable cost ratio? Correct. This is the variable cost ratio formula. So sales is 8 lakhs into 50%, which is 4 lakhs. So I've got my variable cost. Now, since sales quantity remains the same in 2019 and 2020, variable cost per unit also remains unchanged, total variable cost in the year 2020 will be the same as in the year 2019, that is rupees 4 lakh. Guys, correct? So for 2020, I've got my variable cost. Guys, okay. So now in 2020, variable cost is 4 lakh. What is my goal? What is my goal? I have to find the sales. What have they given in 2020? Guys, in 2020, they have given PV ratio 37.5 PV ratio. And I have found out my variable costs. Can I work back to sales? Guys, very simple. PV ratio is given as 37.5. So, can I find out variable cost ratio? Variable cost ratio is 100% minus PV ratio, which is nothing but 100% minus 37.5, which is 62.5%. Which means, what do you mean by variable cost ratio? That variable cost represents so much percentage of sales. Guys, correct? So, I have variable costs. I have the percentage. Can I not find the total? Very simple. So, variable cost ratio is nothing but variable costs divided by sales into 100. Variable cost ratio is 62.5%. Variable cost is 4 lakh. Sales I don't have. Don't take into 100, I've taken 62.5%. Correct? So, how do I calculate this, guys? How much do we get? Six lakh forty thousand. Check this. Guys, is it okay? Can we proceed? So, this first part we have found out. So, sales in 2020 is 6,40,000. Now, what else have they asked us to do? We didn't read only. What have they asked us to do? They've asked us to calculate fixed cost for 2020 in value. They've asked us to calculate the fixed cost. Okay. So, let's calculate the fixed cost, guys. Let's calculate the fixed cost. So, this is part B. Calculation of fixed cost in 2020. Okay. Now, they haven't given any profit figures. We only know the sales. We know the variable cost, we can arrive at contribution. After contribution, nothing else is specified. But they have given us something else. What? They have given us the margin of safety. Correct? They have given us the margin of safety. So, let's do one thing. Let's write this chart there. Just so that it is there in our notes. Okay? 1 minute. So total sales BP sales margin of safety sales in 2019 and in 2020, guys, correct? So what did they give in 2019? They have said margin of safety was 40%, correct? They said margin of safety was 40%. So 40%, which means BEP will be 60%, correct? This is what we understood. And what did we understand from 2020? That margin of safety was 21.875%. So 21.875%, which means BEP will be 78.125%. Guys, we have our total sales. We have already calculated, 640,000. So, if I calculate my BEP sales by using this ratio, I will get my BEP sales. And I know BEP is fixed cost by PV ratio. Can I not calculate my fixed cost? Very simple. So, let's calculate. So, BEP sales in 2020 will be 78.125% of ₹640,000. Correct? That is what it means. So, of the total sales is 640,000. 78.125% is BEP sales. So, how much do you get, guys? How much is this? We get 5 lakhs. So BEP sales is 5 lakhs. But we want fixed cost. Guys, correct? So how do we calculate fixed cost? BEP we know in value is fixed cost divided by PV ratio. Guys, correct? So BEP we calculated how much? 5 lakhs. Fixed cost we don't know. That is what we are supposed to calculate. PV ratio we have for 2020. How much? 37.5%. It is the PV ratio. So let's take 37.5%. So let's calculate, guys. Fixed cost is how much? 5 lakhs into 37.5%. So how much do we get? 187,500. So 187,500 is my fixed cost. 187,500 is my fixed cost. Guys, okay. There is one more part to the problem. What is that? Break-even sales for 2020 in value. We already calculated break-even sales. No? This is the break-even sales. We already calculated it. So, part C is, you just write it down. Part C will be BEP in value in 2020, which is rupees 5 lakhs. How did we calculate this? Show it again. 78.125% into rupees 640,000. That's all. This is your BEP in value. This is the third part of the problem that they have asked, which we already used to calculate the second part. So just show it again because they have asked it as a separate part. question number 4. A company earned profit of 30,000 during the year 2020. So profit which was earned was 30,000. If the marginal cost and selling price of the product are 8 rupees and 10 rupees per unit respectively. So 8 rupees is the variable cost and selling price is 10 rupees per unit. Find out the amount of margin of safety. Find out the amount of margin of safety. Guys, so here in this problem, they have not given us BEP sales, they have not given us actual sales, all that data is not given. What have they given? They have given us profit. There was a formula for margin of safety which uses profit, right? What was that formula? Tell me, what was that formula? So this is question number 4. Question number 4. What was that formula, guys? Margin of safety was profit by PV ratio, if I was calculating it in value, and margin of safety in quantity was profit by contribution per unit, right? This was what margin of safety ka formula was. They have given us profit. So let's use this formula. We will get our margin of safety in quantity, then we will multiply it with selling price and get value. So again, we can avoid calculating PV ratio because contribution is directly given in the problem. So it's not given, we can calculate. Selling price and variable cost is given. So guys, profit is what? Profit is 30,000. Correct. And my marginal cost and selling price are 8 and 10 respectively. So selling price per unit is rupees 10. Less variable cost per unit is rupees 8. So contribution per unit is rupees 2. Correct? Contribution per unit is rupees 2. So can I not calculate MOS quantity very, very easily? What will it be? 30,000 divided by 2 rupees. So I get 15,000 units. MOS quantity is 15,000 units. Guys, I need MOS value. So MOS value will be MOS quantity into selling price per unit. So what is that? 15,000 units into selling price was 10 rupees per unit. So what is the value? 1,50,000. 1,50,000. Very, very simple. Check this out. Guys, done? Okay, then 10 minutes. Fifth problem. A Limited maintains margin of safety of 37.5% with an overall contribution to sales ratio of 40%. Guys, so out of the total sales, they are telling MOS is 37.5%. Right? Which means BEP will be how much? 100 minus 37.5%. Correct? This is what they are telling. And they are telling overall contribution to sales ratio, which means PV ratio is 40%. Okay. Fixed costs amount to 5 lakhs. This is clearly given. So what do we need to do, guys? We need to calculate the following. Break-even sales. We need to calculate the break-even sales. Total sales. Okay. First, we'll do break-even sales. How break-even sales? Fixed cost divided by PV ratio. Fixed cost is also there. PV ratio is also there. Can we not calculate BEP? Very simple. We can calculate. So, let's go to the problem and start calculating, guys. So, Problem number 5, fixed costs, rupees 5 lakhs, PV ratio 40%, VEP in value, how much, fixed cost divided by PV ratio, so 5 lakhs divided by 40%, so how much do we get guys? ₹12,50,000. Very simple, straightforward. Nothing much to do, just use the formula that we already know, right? So this part is done. Guys, what have they asked next? Total sales. They have asked us for total sales. How do we calculate total sales? So this is part one. First of all, part two. We know that MOS percentage of sales is how much? 37.5. Correct? It means BEP percentage of sales is how much, guys? 100% minus MOS percent of sales, which is 100% minus 37.5, which is 62.5. Correct? So MOS percent of sales is 62.5%, which means, BEP percentage of sales is 62.5%, which means of the total sales that I have made, BEP is 62.5%. So how do I find out total sales, guys? I have my BEP sales, which is 12,50,000. I am saying this is 62.5% of total sales. Can I not calculate total sales? If 12,50,000 is 62.5%, how much is 100%? So total sales will be 12,50,000 divided by 62.5%. Divided by 62.5%. So let's do it. How much do you get? We get 20 lakhs. We get 20 lakhs. Guys, correct? This don't write. This is only for your understanding. Okay, this is only for your understanding. So that I can make you understand how I have taken 12,50,000 divided by 62.5%. So we get 20 lakhs as the total sales. This is part 2 of the problem. So very simple. BEP done, total sales done. Now what are they asking us? They're asking us to calculate. Guys, they're asking us to calculate total variable cost. How will you calculate total variable cost? How will you calculate total variable cost? I have total sales. I have my PV ratio. PV ratio is 40%. I want variable cost. So I can calculate variable cost ratio. How much is variable cost ratio? 100% minus PV ratio. So that whatever I get variable cost ratio on sales will give me my variable cost. Very simple. So let's do it. Part 3. Variable costs is what I need to calculate. Correct? So variable cost ratio will be 100% minus PV ratio. 100% minus PV ratio. PV ratio is how much? 40%. So variable cost ratio is 60%. So I know that variable cost ratio is nothing but variable costs divided by sales into 100. So variable cost ratio I have 60%. Variable costs I need to find out. Sales I know is 20 lakhs total. I calculated it as part of the previous problem. Can I not calculate variable cost, guys? So 20 lakhs into 60%. So how much do you get? 12 lakhs. We get 12 lakhs. So my variable costs are 12 lakhs. Guys, moving forward, what else they have they asked in the problem? Current profit. How do we calculate current profit? Once we get our contribution minus fixed cost, gives me profit. Can we not calculate contribution directly? So, point or part 4, I need to find the current profit. Correct? How do I find contribution, guys? Contribution is nothing but sales into PV ratio. Guys, correct? No. We already have this. What is sales? 20 lakhs. PV ratio was 40%. So contribution is 8 lakhs totally. Correct? 20 lakhs was my sales. 40% is my PV ratio. So 40% into 20 lakhs will give me my contribution minus fixed cost. How much are my fixed costs? 5 lakhs. So 5 lakhs. So what does this give me? Profit. How much? 3 lakhs. So my current profit is 3 lakhs. Very, very simple. Or you do sales 20 lakhs minus variable cost 12 lakhs, which you have calculated here. Then you will get contribution 8 lakhs. Then from that you remove fixed cost 5 lakhs. Then you will get 3 lakhs. That also you can do. But it's simply waste of time, long method. But if you are comfortable doing that, please do that. No problem. Like I said, there is no hard and fast rule in this particular chapter. There are so many formulae. You can use anything. As long as you get the right answer. Guys, okay. Now last part, what have they said? New margin of safety if the sales volume is increased by 7.5%. If the sales volume is increased by 7.5%. So come to point number 5. Guys, first of all, margin of safety is what? Actual sales minus BEP sales. Correct? So they are asking us to find out this margin of safety when sales volume has increased by 7.5%. Correct? So guys, what is my new sales volume or new sales value? That is the actual sales now. Original sales was 20 lakhs. Now it is increased by 7.5%. That is what they are saying, right? So what is the new sales value? Can you tell me? New sales value. How much do you get, guys? Yes, 21,50,000. So 21,50,000 is my actual sales now because my volume has increased. So obviously value will also increase. Correct? BEP sales is how much, guys? BEP sales is how much? Have they said anything about BEP sales changing? No, right? They've only told my actual sales have increased by 7.5%, which I have calculated. BEP sales is how much? BEP sales is the same. No, we calculated how much. How much is the BEP sales in part 1 we calculated? 12,50,000. Correct? So, minus 12,50,000. This is my BEP sales. That nothing has changed. So, whatever is remaining is my MOS or margin of safety. So how much is that? 9 lakhs. 9 lakhs. This is my new margin of safety because my sales value has changed. My actual sales have changed. If my actual sales hadn't changed, then my MOS would have been 20 lakh minus 12 lakh 50,000. Guys, correct. That would have been 7 lakh 50,000. But now because my actual sales have changed to 21 lakh 50,000, my MOS value will change to 9 lakh. That is what they have asked. What is the new margin of safety when the sales volume has increased by 7.5%? So this is the way it changes.